Let us take the next problem on single plate clutch. I'll read what is given here. A single plate clutch transmits 25 kilowatts at 900 rpm. The maximum intensity of pressure between the plates is 85 kN per meter square. The outer diameter of the plate is 360 mm. Both sides of the plate are effective and coefficient of friction is 0.25. Determine inner diameter of the plate and axial force to engage the clutch. So this is the question which we have in front of us of single plate clutch. Whatever is given here, I will write this in the form of data first. So let us start this problem by writing the data. The type of clutch, it is single plate. A single plate clutch transmits 25 kilowatts, power is given. 25 kilowatts, I will convert this. It becomes 25 into 10 raised to 3 watts. At 900 rpm, speed is given. The maximum intensity of pressure between the plates is 85 kN per meter square. So P max is 85 kN per meter square. I will convert this. It becomes 85 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 10 raised to 6 mm square. So here I have converted P max from kilonewton per meter square into newton per mm square, and therefore P max will be 85 into 10 raised to minus 3 newton per mm square. Then the outer diameter of the plate is 360. For this, I'll draw the diagram. Outer diameter is D1, that's 360 mm. So therefore, R1 becomes half of 360, that is 180 mm. So here I have outer radius as R1, whose value is 180 mm. Next, it is given that both the sides of the plates are effective. It means N is equal to 2, number of effective sides. Then coefficient of friction is 0.25. So mu is equal to 0.25. Determine inner diameter of the plate. So here I have to calculate how much is D2 inner diameter. For this, I'll calculate R2 and then I would be calculating D2. Then axial force to engage the clutch. Axial force is W, which we can say that it is the axial thrust. Now this much is the data which we have. Whatever I have written in the data, now I would be utilizing it in the problem. And as we can see here, in this problem, power and RPM, they are given. So with that, I can calculate the value of torque. Since power transmitted by single plate clutch, is given by (2π(nt/60). So therefore T will be equal to (P)/60 divided by 2π(n). Power in this problem, it is 25 × 10³ watts given. Divided by 2π(n). RPM is 900. So from this, first I'll get the value of T, and that is 265 0.25 into 10 raised to 3. Here I would be first, I would be getting the value in terms of Newton meter. In Newton meter, the value is 265.25. When I multiply it by 10 raised to 3, that becomes Newton mm. So here I am getting the torque in terms of Newton mm. Next, after this, as we see in the question, we have to calculate inner diameter of the plate and axial force to engage the clutch. So first, I would be finding the inner diameter. For that, I'll say that now in the problem, maximum pressure is given, and we know that maximum pressure will be there at minimum radius. So I'll say that since P max is equal to C upon R2, therefore C is equal to P max into R2. P max is given as 85 into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to minus 3 into R2. So here I have C in terms of R2. Next, axial thrust. Axial thrust is given by 2 pi C into R1 minus R2. Here I don't know the value of R2, so I'll keep axial thrust in the form of R2, that is, I'll write 2 pi C value we have got. R1 is given in the question as it was 180 mm, R1 180 minus R2. So therefore, here I have W is equal to 53.40 R2 into bracket 180 minus R2. So here I am getting W in the form of R2. I will keep this as my first equation. Now I would be calculating the mean radius by uniform wear theory, since nothing is specified about which theory we have to use. So I'll say that by uniform wear theory, since mean radius Rm is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2, therefore R1 is 180 plus R2 by 2. So this is the value of mean radius which we have. Now after this, I'll say that since torque transmitted by single plate clutch T is equal to N mu W into Rm. I'll go on putting the values. Torque was 265.25 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to N is equal to 2 because 2 effective surfaces. Mu, it is 0.25. W, I have in equation number 1. Then Rm, Rm is 180 plus R2 by 2. So from this, if I go on calculating, I would be having the value of R2, because R2 is the only unknown here. So my value of R2, it comes out to be 140 millimeter. So this is my the inner radius. Next, the question is to calculate the inner diameter. So I'll say that D2 is equal to twice of R2. So it is 2 into 140 and D2 value is 280 mm. This is my first answer. And in this question, the second question was to calculate the amount of axial thrust. So axial thrust I am getting in equation number 1. Here I'll put the value of R2 as 140. Put R2 in equation 1. So W is equal to 53.40 into 140 into 180 minus 140. So from this we are getting the value of W as 2990, that is 2990.4 newton, or we can say 2.99 kilonewton. So this is the second answer. As we see in the problem, they were telling us to calculate how much is the inner diameter of the clutch plate. That inner diameter is 280 mm, and to calculate how much is the axial force required so that the clutch is in the engaged position. So to engage the clutch, we require a force of 2.99 kilonewton. And with this, we complete the question.